Science gets in your head, man. Gets in your head and it changes things. Hey, DNews fans, happy anniversary weekend. Your friendly neighborhood neuroscientist, Crystal, here. I've hosted so many videos for you guys that I couldn't even remember my first one, but I'm told it was about memory and optogenetics, which is not surprising because they're two of my favorite things. Optogenetics is the field of study where we use genes that regulate a cell's responses to light to help us control events in a biological system. This gives researchers the ability to literally control the minds of laboratory animals. Turning brain regions on and off allows us to isolate the function of these regions and better understand how they drive specific behaviors. The technique has been used to study all kinds of phenomena, including hunger, fear, and even social behavior. And as we saw in the paper Trace and I discussed in that first video 2 years ago, optogenetics can even be used to manipulate the memories stored in our brain, which is a good thing if we're beginning to forget. Alzheimer's disease is a common cause of brain degeneration, and it typically begins with loss of memory and other impairments in cognitive function. Until recently, it was difficult for scientists to discriminate between impairments in how the memories are stored and the inability for Alzheimer's patients to retrieve their stored memories. So scientists at RIKEN and MIT went about using optogenetics to find out. In a paper published in 2016, researchers took mice that had been genetically modified to have an Alzheimer's-like condition and to be responsive to optogenetic manipulation and taught them to be afraid of something. Then they split them into two groups. One did not receive optogenetic treatment and the other one did. Then both groups of mice were re-exposed to what they were taught to be afraid of. The untreated group forgot they were supposed to be afraid, but the other group didn't. The differences in memory retention were the result of changes in special memory cells in the hippocampal region of the brain. These particular cells have spiky bumps on them, located on a part of the cell called the dendrite. The spiky bumps make up what's called the dendritic spine. Think of it like the spine in your back, which has bumps from the vertebrae. These are crucial to our brain's ability to adapt and learn. And when these spikes go away, like they do in Alzheimer's disease, so do the memories in those cells that express them. Optogenetic treatment can prevent or reduce this loss. In this study, scientists use a fiber optic cable to stimulate the memory cells with blue light. Now remember, the mice they were using had been genetically modified to have optically responsive neurons. This kind of treatment would not work with any old mouse on the street. We knew that the treatment worked because the memory cells of the mice maintained their spinal density, and the mice retained their memory of fear. This indicates that this type of treatment could one day be an effective strategy for treating memory loss in the early stages of Alzheimer's disease. Because optogenetics requires genetic modifications in the cells, the technique can currently only be applied to animals in the laboratory. But with the rapid advancement of genome editing by CRISPR-Cas9 and new advances in getting these genetic modifications into the brain, this science might be inside your head before you know it. The results of scientific investigation made possible by optogenetics have widespread implications for the treatment of many human conditions. 2 years ago, we were discussing possible therapy for PTSD. This year, it's Alzheimer's disease. It'll be exciting to see what progress we can make towards understanding memory and how to manipulate it in the next 2 years. But for now, if you're like me and can't remember that first video, here's an opportunity to remember. What's your favorite memory? Subscribe to DNews and let us know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching.